good morning. Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening for the one who attending from online. My name is Danif Danusaputra. I'm the CEO of Pertamina Power New and Renewable Energy. I'm here today to explain about the role of Pertamina New Renewable Energy in decarbonizations and also particularly related to geothermal. Pertamina is actually leading on the sustainable has a leading commitment on sustainability through different what you call the policies. The action is actually had by the CEO of Pertamina itself, right? We want to become the reputable and leading global energy. And we also adhere to international standard on sustainability practice. And currently, that's where we are in terms of the rating. There's room for improvement. Pertamina focus on 8 initiatives, right, to initiate the decarbonizations. Number one is on geothermal. Geothermal is key renewable energy sources for Indonesia. I'm going to spend time explaining why geothermal is key and one of the key sources of renewable energy for Indonesia. And we do have close to 700 megawatt of installed capacity, and we are expanding rapidly to 1.1 giga in the next 5 years. And we also would like to expand into beyond energy of geothermal. And the second initiative that we have is on hydrogen, right? This is a key initiative, key strategic initiative for Pertamina. We do believe this is one of the key sources of green energy for sectors that's difficult to abate on the decarbonizations. So we plan to have several pilot projects, and one of which is to produce green hydrogen from geothermal. And then the third initiative is related to EV ecosystem, electric vehicle system, and energy storage and system. This is an exciting sector, exciting segment where it involves retails, passengers cars, transportations or whatnot. Pertamina involvement is through participation in IBC, Indonesia Battery Corporation, a joint venture to produce end-to-end battery supply chain system. We plan to produce EV battery for up to 140 gigawatt by 2029, and to develop, this is most important, right, to develop an ecosystem for EV, for swapping battery or charging EV ecosystem. Gasifications, plan to have a methanol plant to be on stream by 2025. And then obviously Pertamina going into downstream, we will have more of refinery and petrochemical, and the new refinery petrochemical will be green refinery. Now the other initiative is for bioenergy, right? This is to generate energy from biomass, biogas, and also blending gas oil and gasoline from algae and ethanol. The other initiative that we have is through circular carbon economy by doing recycling of biomass and biogas, reduce of fossil fuel energy by implementing a solar PV project, EV, doing LNG, gas, and then reuse. This is reusing them CO2 for the purpose of EOR and methanol. And the last is not least is actually to implement and executing more of new and renewable energy project, such as solar PV, wind, and hydro, which reflected in the latest RUPTL and also Pertamina participated with other SOE on producing a DMA. This will be planned to be on stream by 2025. Now we talk about geothermal. This is why geothermal is important as source of key renewable energy for Indonesia. As you can see here, Indonesia has one of the largest, if not the largest, geothermal reserve and resource, right? And from the install capacity, we are number two in the world, just behind United States. But the utilization of the reserve of resource is only about less than 10%. Hence, a lot of a potential upside to expand the capacity and also the utilization of geothermal energy. This is, you can see from the map, there are quite dispersed locations of geothermal reserve, and the utilization is still quite low, right, compared to the potential reserve and reserve that we have. Obviously, most of demand is in Sumatra, Jawa, and Bali, but you can see the utilizations of reserve and reserve is still very low, right? This is where there's huge opportunity for explorations and utilizations of geothermal energy. And then this is also to help the Indonesia energy mix, which is in line with the national energy strategy, to increase new and renewable energy from the current level of less than 13% to target of 24% by 2030. And geothermal will be one of the key factor for it. This is I'm going to spend quite a bit of time on this because we should look geothermal as renewable energy sources beyond electrifications, beyond just selling as an energy into the grid, right? There are other beyond energy that benefit that we can get from explorations and commercializations of geothermals, such as the mineral extractions. This is one thing that, you know, sometimes we do not see in quite details. There's potentials on the lithium and silica, green hydrogen, geothermal is, other than hydro, is maybe the only renewable energy that doesn't have intermittency issues. Hence, you know, we can produce green hydrogen, right, through electrolysis process from geothermal without any on the intermittent issues. Green ammonia, obviously this is the utilization of green ammonia, is the derivative from green hydrogen. This is, it can be used for commercializations for the use of energy to other sectors such as agriculture and also fertilizer. And the other two is related to how we can increase the commercialization of hydrogen. One of which is actually to utilize brine to power. This is to improve and to utilize the brine gas that usually as a as a side product of geothermal gas. And the last but not least, this is quite common nowadays actually on the district power industrial estate, of which where there's new development of industrial estate, and the source of the energies come from renewables, which is more and more in demand from the industrial player because of the requirement from their stakeholders. This is the last slide. I just want to give you very high level where we are in terms of Pertamina geothermal energy, right? We are in the process of doing consolidations of geothermal asset owned by state-owned enterprise, other state-owned enterprise, and also in a government entity, because we believe economic scale does matter, right? So we believe this will benefit not only to us as a business player, but also for contribution of the Indonesian commitment from NDC and support the RUPTL and obviously as provider into the grid without any into the grid without any intermittent issue. So I stop here. So basically, I just want to close that Indonesia does matter, right? In this global decarbonization, and geothermal is one of the key renewable energy sources that we need to keep pursue and producing. Thank you very much.